In this video, we're going to begin to look at division of polynomials. We have done addition and subtraction by combining like terms. We've looked at a variety of techniques of multiplication, and now we're going to look at division, and we're going to start with division by a monomial. Remember that a monomial is a single term, and when we divide by monomial, we're going to use the quotient rule. So let me remind you of that. The quotient rule tells you that if you have the same base in the top and the bottom, in other words, a quotient, and there are exponents involved, then the quotient is found by keeping the base x to the a minus b power. If that results in a negative number, then you'll have to do some moving. But we're going to be using this quotient rule over and over when we divide by a monomial. Let's take a look. All right, the first one. I have 11x to the fifth plus 9x to the third over x. Well, the denominator is a monomial, one term. So I'm going to break this up to 11x to the fifth over x plus 9x to the third over x. Now, each one of those can be simplified using the quotient rule. Remember that that particular denominator of x is really x to the first. So the first term will become 11x to the 5 minus 1 is 4 plus 9x to the 3 minus 1, which is 2. And that's my quotient. And that's why I said we needed to review the quotient rule. From now on, when I write down the problem from here to over here, I'm going to go ahead and break it into the individual fractions. So the next one is 7x to the third over 7 plus 21x to the second over 7 minus 35x over 7 minus 49 over 7. I'm dividing by the monomial, which happens to be a constant in this case, of 7. What will that give me? Well, I'm just going to be dividing the numerical coefficients. So I'm going to end up with x to the third, implied 1x to the third, plus 3x squared minus 5x minus 7. And that's my quotient. Next one, I've got 24p to the fourth over 4p plus 8p to the third over 4p. That will give me 6p to the 4 minus 1 is 3 plus 8 divided by 4 is 2p to the 3 minus 1, which is 2. And that's all there is. Let's look at number 4. I have negative 20x to the 6th over 8x to the 7th plus 40x to the 7th over 8x to the 7th. Well, now the first one. There's a couple of different ways I can handle it. Obviously, 8 does not go into negative 20 evenly. It does reduce. 4 is a common factor. 4 goes in there negative 5 times. 4 goes in there 2 times. Now, I'm going to simplify this part really twice. The easiest way is to say, well, there are 6 factors of x on top, 7 factors of x on the bottom. These 6 knock out 6 of these, leaving 1, but it's on the bottom. That's one way to do it. Another way, I'm going to go right over here and show. I still have the negative 5 over 2. X to the 6 minus 7, which would be negative 5 over 2, x to the negative 1. Well, x to the negative 1 says move me to the bottom. The bottom would be negative 5 over 2, put the x with it because now it's on the bottom, to the positive 1, and I wouldn't write a 1. That was much more involved. Got me to the same result. All right, so that is not my preferred way to do it, but I did want to at least show it. Plus, 40 divided by 8 is 5. X to the 7th over x to the 7th. Those divide out, so I just have 5. All right, last one. 18x to the 4th over 9x minus 63x to the 3rd over 9x plus 45x over 9x. 18 divided by 9 is 2. X to the 4 minus 1 is 3. Minus 63 divided by 9 is 7. X to the 2nd plus 5. Because 9 goes into 45 5 times, those X's cancel out. And there's my quotient. So division by a monomial turns out to be really nothing more than repeatedly using the quotient rule. We'll look at division by binomials in future lessons.